Brian Lawton joining us. We're thrilled to have you as part of this discussion, understanding just how much you value information. Following up on Montgomery's point, how, as a GM, do you determine what of this information, and there is a lot of it, benefits your club?
Well, information is definitely knowledge in this game. There's no doubt about that. And the general managers have picked up really where the coaches have led, I think, in a lot of ways with how they're using analytics, particularly for their systems play, but also for their player performance reviews or player evaluations. And that's really where the GMs have jumped into it as well. I talk to more and more guys that are specifically looking for players that do certain things. And when I think about a guy like Victor Hedman and maybe Ryan McDonagh as a pair, you can back up into all the analytics that are available today. And Mike Kelly sitting right there knows as well as anybody from his interactions with Sports Logic that we can measure just about anything in this game. McDonagh, Hedman, these are two guys I think that squeeze plays off before the blue line better than anybody else. Never really had that stat before. You never really kept track of that. You always trusted your eyes. And I think that general managers are looking at more and more things like that. They're looking for the players maybe on a line that are drivers. This is really easy, right? Connor McDavid, he would be a guy that carries or drives a line. You can put him maybe with other guys that we might consider complementary players. Look no further maybe than the end of last season with Connor when a player like Ty Ratty comes up to the NHL, has played NHL games previously with the St. Louis Blues, but not had near the amount of success that he had when he was with a true driver player like Connor McDavid, where he scored 9 points essentially in 14 games. A lot of optionality for general managers. They're jumping on this new information age, and I think a lot of them are doing an excellent job.
So, Brian, you talk about a lot of things on the macro level. You can talk about draft picks and talk about making trades and performance reviews. What about on a day-to-day thing? When you get information, how do you filter it down from your office to the coach's office and then ideally to the players and maybe impacting what they're doing on the ice? Can you do that, game by game, week by week?
As a general manager, you're always doing that in your evaluations. That's what you're meeting with your pro scouts for. That's why you're really sharpening up the list. When I went to Tampa, they had an evaluation system that I didn't feel was giving that to me. As a matter of fact, about 38% of the league was almost the same player by our evaluation. So now you can take all this data, plug it in, and come up with a more of a, let's say for forwards, 1 to 400 list. Or for D, 1 to a couple hundred list. And you can really fine-tune down as to which player you might want in a trade, because it comes down to that. It can't be that everybody's kind of a 3 rating. That just doesn't do you any good, and that's where teams have done a much better job. As far as coaches, what I see them doing better than ever is they're evaluating players on their own merits more clearly. And what I mean by that is when they're making lineup decisions, they may be looking for a guy that hasn't necessarily scored a lot of points, but he's been a positive influence on the team every night. You can do that now with analytics, and you know that as well as anybody, Mike.
Brian, one of the first things that I learned when I really started getting into this heavy data sets that we work with is numbers don't tell you everything. They're incredibly important, but there seems to still exist to a lesser degree, well, it's numbers versus eye test. And how do you balance these two things when I think a lot of people now realize that when you work with them in concert, you get the best results from that. As somebody who's been a general manager and has played and has been an agent, you've done all these things. How would you, if you were running a team now, make sure that it got balanced properly with the people, the scouting department, the video guys, so that everybody can understand the importance of it, but not pushing people out that may be a little resistant to it as well?
Yeah, and there clearly are, Mike. Back in 08, 09, 10, when I was running the Lightning, this was something that I came across often. And I would always default to, hey, guys, I'm not saying don't trust your eyes. Just look deeper. It's not always what you think you see, particularly for the coaches. The game is so fast. Having been a player, I've never been a coach in an NHL game, but having been a player on that bench for a number of games, enough to recognize that what you think you saw isn't always the case. I think now, as you see more and more guys want to use analytics, you still have to give people the freedom to feel confident in their eyes. But it's the combination of the two, as you just mentioned, Mike, that I think is really powerful for a franchise. I think a team like the Blackhawks, you know, really looking back, not last year necessarily, but 5-6 years ago, some of the things that they were doing systematically as a team, some of the things that they were doing in evaluating players and how they would fit into their lineup, I thought were really groundbreaking. As with all things, that's tightening. And now we're looking for that maybe next advantage. Vegas coming into the league last year, I watched some of the things they did on their zone entries. I thought they were a little bit of a dynamic shift from what we'd seen the previous few years. And we all know what kind of success they had with it.
We've heard you talk about zone entries before. In terms of a category in the realm of analytics that really stands out, would you highlight that as one that has special significance when we look at the impact it can have?
It does for me, Tony. And you got to be careful here because there's a difference between meaningful and measurable. And now that we have this rage of analytics, we can literally measure which way Mike Johnson jumps over the bench. Does he go left foot first or right foot first? Doesn't really matter at the end of the day. You want to try to zero in on the things. And this is what Jim Montgomery means when he's talking about things that are key or core to his team. I see a lot of teams, like I'm very curious to see how a guy like Bill Peters, who I know uses analytics, who I know coaches DeCourcy to some degree, I think they averaged about maybe just under 34 shots a game last year. Now he changes to the Calgary Flames. They averaged almost that amount as well, but that team is much more skilled. Carolina, we know, didn't score maybe at the levels that you thought you would with the way they played. I think that's going to change this year. I think we're going to see Calgary, who really under Glenn Gullickson played an up-tempo style as well, put a lot of pucks on net and had success with it. But I think Bill Peters coaches to another level in that respect. And I'm curious to see if we see those numbers reflect that at the end of the year, if the Calgary Flames have a big season this season.
You've given us a lot to think about as always. Lots, thanks so much for joining us.
My pleasure, guys.